It's only a television program. It's the Xtra Factor with Holly Willoughby.
Oh, yes. It's Michael Jackson night, and boy, are we bad, because this is the Xtra Factor, the show that throws out Louis' rulebook straight out the window, because we are more interested in what you have to say. Now, sadly, the King of Pop may not be with us, but his legacy continues. And tonight, this is incredible, we have his actual glove here in the studio. How amazing is that? Very exciting. Oh, she's not here. Where's Hilda? Ah. I wanted to come and speak. You're Joe's granny, aren't you? Yeah. Now, Simon said tonight that you could be in any of his shows. What do you think?
Well, it depends on if I'm vacant or not.
She's got a very busy diary, has our Hilda. Big round of applause for Hilda here. So, the question is, what did you make of Michael Jackson tonight? Was it a thriller? Should our judges beat it? Well, there's only one way to tell us, and here's how. You've called, you've ranted, but they can't wimp out, because we're going to make them face your wrath once again. It's our X-Factor judges! Cheryl just said to me, please make them be nice, it's the semi-final! Don't think that's going to happen. No. And also, I just spoke to Hilda, and she said she's very busy, and she might try and find a space in her diary.
Oh, so she's not calling in tonight?
Oh, no, not Hilda. This is Joe's grandma.
Oh, I
who's on the BT. Sorry.
Job,
I should have explained
that. I didn't know your first name, sweetheart.
Well, now you're on first
I
name.
I love term. Hilda.
I know, she's great.
Yeah, she's sweet.
So, should we see what the rest of the nation is saying?
I have been very complimentary to Joe week after week, so I don't think that's been playing mind games.
But I think what Sue's saying is that by being complimentary to him, it's going to have some kind of reverse psychology, so people go, oh, he's safe.
Absolute nonsense.
But she is right what she says, that the public decides, so they hear what's going
but
on.
But Cheryl, everybody... just to be clear, I complimented him twice tonight.
Yeah, everybody
so there's
knows
no
that.
Issue.
Cheryl, good evening, Lorna.
Hiya.
Hello, what would you like to say?
I was just wondering, my question is to all of the judges. Cheryl, since she's joined the show as a judge, she's been absolutely fantastic.
Oh,
last year, winning with Alexandra, and this year, getting a good contender with Joe as a favourite to win. I was just wondering, what is it that you think Cheryl's doing right that the other judges are not?
I don't know. Louis, you answer that one.
Well, I mean, we're as good as the acts that we get to mentor, you know. But and she did win last year with Alexander, but I did pretty well with JLS. They're actually selling more records at the moment, I think.
Yeah, exactly.
So.
I like JLS. I love JLS. I'm a big fan.
Yeah.
But JLS didn't win.
Lorna, we're only as good as the... Well, I think they've won in the charts, darling. If you look at the charts and the sales...
OK, Lorna, what I would say, and I don't want to take any credit for this, but I think if you watch the tape, you'll find me when... saying when Joe first came in he could win the competition. Yeah. So
No, Simon, you said when Joe first came in that he were nothing but a Broadway singer.
No.
And obviously he proved himself not to be
Lorna,
a Broadway singer. Because you suddenly changed your mind, you and Louis.
No, Lorna, I think we're watching different shows.
We like Joe.
We like him.
We're as good as the categories we get to mentor, you know.
Lorna, thanks for your call.
No, you can't.
I can't win. If you praise them you get criticised. If you don't you get criticised.
Cheryl, you could win for the second year in a row. Have you thought about that?
No, Louis is right. You know, I have been fortunate enough to have two fantastic categories. Alexandra was in a league of her own, and Joe is fantastic. So I don't view it like I'm going to win. I view it like Joe could potentially
win. It's wide open, yeah. Anybody can win it.
Danny, I wanted to ask you about Stacey, because last week you said on the show you were going to get her up a bit more singing and dancing, and tonight we saw a completely different side to her. It was a real sort of risk, I guess, at the semi-final to do that.
Yeah, I guess it was, but I really wanted to do what Stacey felt true about, and she really wanted to go.
Would you like to call?
Yeah, number three, please.
Number three, confidence boost. This is Aaron. Hi, Aaron.
Hi,
oh,
you?
Jenny! Hello again. Hi. Lovely to hear from you. What's a girl to do?
Exactly.
Oh, no, it's this one.
What did Daniel sing on his last song? Well, let's put it this way.
What did Daniel sing on his last song? Jenny, you've got to...
What are you doing about it?
I'm worried about you, Jenny.
I'm going to ask you this question again. What did Daniel sing on his...
Yeah,
Okay, everybody happy with their performances tonight? The semi-finalists? I know, Louis, you can't answer this, but...
Well, I can. Of course I can. I thought there were some brilliant performances. World-class standard singers.
Performance of the night for you.
Oh, Daniel or Joe.
Can you not... Are you really...
Both were fantastic. Both were... And Stacey's second song somewhere was good, too.
Are you guys all going to pick your own artists if I ask you this?
And Stacey.
You are, aren't you? And Stacey, okay, that's the first time you've ever done that. All right, well, listen, thank you very much. Tomorrow is going to be a big night, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. Your judges...
And good night, Jenny.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Join us after the break as tonight's cross examination continues with Gavin and Stacey's Matthew Horne, Radio God Scott Mills and the Daily Star's James Ingham. So there's no need for a DNA test. We're 100% yours. Welcome back to the Xtra Factor, and it's Michael Jackson night! Hello, Michael Jackson. Now, it's that time of the week where we welcome a panel of celebs via a completely unnecessary funny intro. So, here we go. This weekend, we've already got a semi-final, that is, but now we've got the horn! It's Matthew Horne! He's definitely on our frequency, and he's about to give you a wave. It's Radio 1, Scott Mills. We booked him because he sounded good on paper. It's the Daily Star's James Ingham. Let's go catch up. Hello. I can only apologise for that link in there, Matthew.
I loved it.
Good.
I loved it, yeah.
Good. So, semi-final night. It's a big night. Notoriously on the X Factor, it's the one that obviously nobody wants to leave. It's the final hurdle, if you like. So, what did you think?
Well, as you say, you know, we're getting towards the end now, so... the wheat has been separated from the chaff and everybody who's left is really, really good. So it's really tough, but it's the first time I've been here, so I loved it.
So who was your favourite?
Tonight, my favourite was probably Joe, Stacey a close second, and then King Ollie. But I love Daniel as well. I thought they were all brilliant. They were fantastic.
I'm so sorry
to sit on the fence, but they were great.
It's really difficult because I think, as always happens with these competitions, people that start out very strong at the beginning, it sort of all changes. And Joe, to begin with, nobody was really talking about that much.
He was completely off my radar for ages, and then suddenly he's like, amazing.
And he was great tonight.
Yeah, I think my favourite tonight. I worry about a couple of the... like the arrangement of the song for Ollie, the We Can Work It Out, like... It's a song that everybody knows, and if you can't sing along with it, which you couldn't really, and that the way it had been arranged, and that worries me.
She should have done a slower song like Joe did.
Yeah. Okay. And what about Daniel? Because there was a certain point after the first song when all of the judges had said to the other contestants, "You deserve a place in the." Who now that obviously Jed would have gone? Who at the press sort of backing to win? Because
definitely Joe.
Really.
I think so.
But that wasn't always the case, was it?
He's starting to nail the performances now, though, isn't he? Week after week.
Yeah.
And he's a nice lad. You can't pick a fault with him. There's nothing wrong with him at all, so...
OK. All right. Is that enough for an art that he's nice and that he's got this...
But he's coming out with the best performances each week.
Do you know, he's perfect.
Yeah, he's not putting in a bad performance at all throughout the whole show.
OK. Well, there's a bit in the press today about Daniel and Ollie, and... I don't know whether you can shed some light on this, but apparently there's been this argument going on that the winner...
Is Joe not getting involved in this argument?
No, apparently not. I mean, it just says that it's Daniel and Ollie that have spoken up. Joe's too nice. He's just going, whatever. The afro. Apparently, she's after the afro here. Is there any truth in this, or is this just...
Who knows with Jordan? She could be after anyone, can't she? The latest is apparently she wants to get a close into Joe.
Not Joe!
She's after Gareth Gates Mark too, so...
Oh, my goodness.
Poor little Joe, better watch out.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my goodness. Well,
imagine.
She'd eat him alive.
Tiger.
She most certainly would. Well, listen, guys, who's your winner?
Joe.
Winner, Scott?
Joe.
Winner.
I think Joe will win, but I think he should be here in 3-4 years. I think it's probably too young for him.
So who would you like to win?
Daniel.
Really? Well, listen to that. Thank you very much. All tomorrow night, all should be revealed who our finalists are. Thank you very much, celebrity panel. Now, whilst our ITV1 show may show off with their big video screens and pyrotechnics, the purse strings are a little bit tighter here. But after a quick whip round, we scraped together enough money to head up to the north to find out what the folks of Newcastle have to say. Oh, has anyone got a penny for the meter?
Galaxy. It's Monday, we're talking about how much we love Joe. Can he win the X Factor? What do you reckon?
Get hundreds of calls in from people really going crazy about Joe.
You love Joe.
I do, Marshall, I love him, yeah.
Gotta do it for the Geordies, Joe. Come on.
We've been taking bets over the last couple of months on the X Factor. We've got odds on the winning judge, Cheryl's favourite, at 4-6.
Yes, to the final.
Simon's 11-4. Danny's 3-1. And obviously, Louise, that was a run.
Good for Joe. Yes. And I want to adopt him.
I think I was going
to
cry there.
Here in the Shields Gazette, we've launched a Go Joe campaign. We're doing stories every day about Joe because there's such a huge interest. But frankly, people just can't get enough of Joe in here in South Glasgow. We're backing Joe on the road to stardom.
So there you go, that's what's been going up there, up north. Now, like a cow with a speech impediment, all this lot have shouted at the judges for the last hour and a half on ITV1 is boo. So we thought we'd give them a chance to widen their vocabulary. It's up people's back. This is when it all gets a little bit serious.
I think so, yeah. Because I didn't really recognise it until they got into it a bit, and it just seemed a little lapse in a bit from the first song.
It must be scary for Ollie, because obviously, as a boy, did you enjoy that?
I thought the first performance was actually quite weak.
Who is in Joe's camp? Because the panel are.
Anyone like Joe?
Yeah. No?
I think he has turned around tonight. I think he's done fantastic.
Don't know whether to live or die, and it cuts like a knife. She's out of my life. So now I come. Nothing too high.
Welcome back to the Xtra Factor. Now, if you're too lazy to stalk our semi-finalists, you'll be pleased to know that this week we've done the hard work for you. Here is the semi-final week that was.
Monday morning, Michael Jackson week. Ow! Time for it. Oh!
We're all off to rehearsals.
So Ollie's in a nice little pose, and so I'm going to draw a little picture of him. I'm a brilliant artist.
No.
That's Ollie.
Do you see the resemblance there?
Just drawing Joe.
You know when we're drawing you? We just need to draw some of that greasy hair off your first audition.
Hello.
Hiya.
It wasn't greasy, it was just shiny.
But Joe had the sweatiest face I've ever seen.
Dance with my father again.
This is Dan, because when he smiles, he squints. His eyes squint up. See? Actually, isn't that bad.
What is your
Stevie?
A
fossil. You've just like me. Thanks, Joe. Thanks for waking me up for that. Really appreciate it.
Come back here for choreography.
We are going to the Michael Jackson exhibition at the O2 Arena. Well, I can't do it on the gravel.
Moonwalk. Awesome.
Michael Jackson has a crown. I really want a crown.
It's Michael Jackson's gloves of many, many colours. So I just remember the silver one, look.
Let's have a look at these music awards. I would love to win a music video award one day. But really, if I took that, pull that off and get another thing engraved, then it's pretty secure. Me and you have a competition. Daniel hold my feet, Ollie will hold yours. Who can lean the furthest forward?
Ollie's big head was in the way.
Well done, you won that, you won that, very good. Right, we are joined by the Fab Four right now! And look, look, guys, how exciting is this? This is Michael Jackson's club. Don't touch.
Don't get too close to me.
Now, it is currently on display at the Michael Jackson exhibition at the O2. Can I just say, it's covered in Swarovski crystals. It's worth $500,000. It was worn during the Victory Tour Pepsi commercial. He wore it when he won 8 Grammys and when he got his star on the Walk of Fame. How phenomenal is that?
Wow, pretty phenomenal.
How much is that?
It's a glove. It's almost as phenomenal as your performances tonight, I might add.
I don't know. Hopefully it'll go well. You never know.
Hopefully. OK. Joe, I mean, beforehand, you said that you were really nervous, but you looked so calm and so in control of what you were doing tonight.
I didn't feel it. Literally this week has been the worst week for nerves. It's like I've literally felt physically sick all week.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it just because you know that you're so close?
Yeah. And it's literally now, like, one falter, and that could be it, and I think that's more the pressure now.
We spoke to your granny about possibly coming on the show and being part of one of Simon's future products. She said she might be busy.
Yeah.
I have to check the diary. Bless her heart. Ollie, so, dancing tonight. There was a lot of it. You went for it, didn't you?
I just went absolutely crazy with it tonight. I just thought, you know, this could be my last performance, you know, so I just thought I'm going to have it every single moment, you know, enjoy it as well. And again, the crowd were great tonight. They're always great. You know, every week we come in here and we perform in front of such a good crowd. And I just loved it. It was really good.
Do you kind of feel, because obviously this is sort of the final hurdle now.
I'm in the final four, and I think if I go tomorrow, I'll be devastated, of course. Yeah. But, you know, I think that to be in this group of people with the talent that's here, you know, I wouldn't have thought in a million years, so I'm really chuffed to be here, and hopefully they'll pick up the phone and vote. So.
And you'll be here next week too.
Hopefully, yeah.
Like, and hate me and love me, so that's why I kind of got used to it.
Cheryl said tonight, with your first performance, that she could see that you were physically shaking. Mm. Were you extra nervous tonight?
I think we're all nervous. I think Joe was the most nervous, but I think we're all kind of really nervous just being out there, because it means sort of so much to everyone. So.
Yeah. Well, I have to say, you couldn't see it on the TV where I was watching. You couldn't see you
up
shaking
close,
then,
I was like, yeah.
But yeah. Do you think you've done enough?
You can never say you've done enough. It's up to the public to vote now, and you know, and everyone's sort of splitting the board right now.
Does anyone think they're actually going home?
I think we all do.
Yeah.
Honestly, like, you know when you just think... everyone got really good comments, and I think mine were the worst out of everyone's. Yeah, they were, out of everyone's. And I just think, I don't know, there's nothing you can do now, so no point worrying about it.
Have a chat a little bit after the break. It is time for a break now, but when we return, we'll be letting you, the great British public, speak to the semi-finalists. The country wants it, so we give it. Welcome back to the Xtra Factor. In honour of the King of Pop this week, our finalists have spent a lot of time inappropriately grabbing their crotches and shouting. But if you want to see what else they've been up to, then this is it.
We're going to meet Faye. Here we go. We're gonna go crazy.
This is a snood. It's nice, isn't it?
I am welly obsessed.
Spot me while I'm doing that. No,
that's a joke. That's a joke.
Da. Too late, I've got them.
Oh, don't fight children.
Let me try these.
No,
you try these.
She's not holding these glasses for mine.
They were in my section and he stole them.
They were all chopped out.
That was the funniest thing ever. We're going bowling.
Yeah! I'm going bowling too. Woohoo!
He's gonna lose.
One rule about bowling club is all you always lose.
What?
Strikes than anyone else. And the winner takes it all. Me, who's best man won.
The only way they can win is by cheating.
Should we go to some callers? Joe, we've got a caller for you. Who's on the line? It's Vanda. Hi, Vanda.
Hi, Holly, all right?
I'm very good, thank you. What would you like to ask Joe?
Well, first of all, they're all good, all really, really good. But Joe is outstanding.
Oh, thank you.
And the question I want to ask Joe is, which performance of all the contestants have you been the most jealous of?
Probably one of the dance numbers, because I really want to dance. saw, the ones that were, have had lots of choreography in, I'm like, oh, I want that.
Want some, like, Hit Me Baby One More Time with Jedward?
Secretly, really wanted Baby Hit Me One More Time. Oops, I did it again. Oops, I did it again.
He did. Can you imagine him doing that?
No.
Thank you very much for your phone call. Thank you.
I was going to say, I predicted the winner now the last 7 years, and I think Joe is going to win it this year.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Vanda. Thank you. Right, let's go for one. We've got Mel on the line for Stacey. Hi, Mel.
Hi, Holly.
Hello.
Hi,
what would you like to say? Fire away, Mel.
Hi, Stacey. Friends with.
Huh? Mel?
Have you got a party piece that you amuse your friends with?
Hello.
Would you like a call?
I'd love a call.
Okay, this is Dee on the line. Hi. Dean, sorry. Holly. Hi, Dean. How
are
you?
Okay. That's probably the writing.
An email here. This is a great question. I can't believe I've never asked you this myself. From Faith. She says, do you guys all vote for yourselves?
No.
Are you allowed to?
I don't think you're allowed.
I've got no credit.
I've got my go as well. So yeah,
I don't think we're allowed though.
No, I don't think we are.
Well, listen, guys, thank you so much. Tomorrow night we'll find which three of you are going through to our final. I know. I'm so scared for you. Try and get some sleep. Big round of applause for yourselves, I think. Well, that is it for your first instalment of the Xtra Factor Bumper Weekender. Thanks to our judges panel, finalists, and Michael Jackson's glove. It's been an honour. Tomorrow night, we'll be dishing up a second helping in form of Peter Andre and the Saturdays, as well as giving the judges another barrage of fierce questioning just from you. Plus, we'll be saying so long to another act and chatting to your three finalists. So make sure you're back here tomorrow night at 8:30. I'll see you then. Good night.